Hello, everyone. I'm Jillian Schwiep, a director of product management at DataRobot. And I'm excited to show you the new DataRobot experience that we've designed to help teams collaborate easily and rapidly speed up experimentation. Now, we all know that in reality, in data science, many ML projects actually end up failing and not delivering value. Recent research shows that nearly 50% of AI projects fail. Why? Because it's hard. ML projects and artifacts are scattered across local and shared systems, making it difficult to manage your own projects, let alone collaborate on projects. It's hard to access clean data to work with, and it's a pain to run multiple end-to-end experiments. It's even harder to iterate quickly and keep everything organized. Then, if you do finally get the right model, it's really tricky to put the results of that model into the hands of business stakeholders in a way that makes sense for them. Let me show you how we are tackling these challenges head-on through a host of new offerings in the DataRobot AI platform. This is the new DataRobot Workbench. We built this because our customers have asked us to organize all of their machine learning assets from a business opportunity into a single place. We call this container a use case. Here, we are managing all of our use cases. You can quickly review who has access to each use case, when it was last modified, and how many data sets, experiments, apps, and notebooks each one contains. We can return to our DataRobot Classic UI from the top menu, but let's open the hospital readmissions use case to see our current progress. The use case info is displayed on the sidebar so that anyone can quickly see the business value in this description. You can easily share a use case with other AI builders under specific roles without having to manage access to each asset, allowing you to ensure restricted access to sensitive projects. While DataRobot experimentation tools are all accessible here in the UI, you can also use notebooks for a code-first experience using the DataRobot APIs or any other data science framework. Let's take a look at this notebook that we previously created to explore our readmissions dataset. DataRobot notebooks are a fully managed, hosted platform for creating and executing notebooks. We have adjustable compute resources and pre-built images with a single click so that you don't have to worry about infrastructure. And how many times have you had to write boilerplate code from scratch in a blank notebook? DataRobot now raises the standard for notebooks with our frequently used code snippets, so you can stay laser-focused on creative experimentation and spend less time reading docs. DataRobot notebooks also have a built-in revision history, so you can checkpoint and revert to previous versions of the notebook. Our notebooks automatically authenticate the API on your behalf, so you have a seamless coding experience. I've loaded the data into a data frame, and I did some basic data analysis using the Pandas library, which comes pre-installed in the default image. I could keep going here, and I can solve my business use case just using the DataRobot notebook and APIs. But let's solve this use case using just UI so that I can show you visually how easy it is to iterate. To get started, we can add some data to our use case. And there are multiple ways to add data. You can either select a local file and upload that. You can select a data set that's registered in the data registry that maybe a colleague might have uploaded and shared with you. Or you can connect to popular cloud data warehouses and lakes, starting with Snowflake today. For Snowflake, you can configure the connection parameters and authentication details as required, and then you can browse your Snowflake landscape, explore schemas, and preview tables and views before deciding to add the data to your use case to wrangle it. Here we can see a preview of the data. We can see the features in the data, and then we can go ahead and begin preparing the data. Multiple operations can be carried out here. You can compute new values, do all sorts of filtering and more. And these transformations are pushed down into Snowflake, which means that you can leverage the security and governance of your data warehouse. Here you can see that we are running exploratory data analysis on this data set automatically. That way we can see the distribution of every feature in this data. So let's go take a look at an experiment I already ran. DataRobot ran dozens of models for me, and we can see all of these trained models on the left-hand side. You can quickly toggle to another experiment in your use case. Here I did an experiment predicting the number of procedures that a given patient might have. You can also view experiment info to understand what dataset, target, and partitioning was used. You can go ahead and filter models in a certain model family or other tags, and you can sort models based on the partition or metric that you care about. Let's take a look at some model insights. Here I've got this light gradient boosted trees classifier, and right away I can pull up some of the insights that matter to me as a data scientist. The lift chart, the ROC curve, and feature impact. Having these insights built in helps you analyze model performance and assess what to do in your next iteration. This insight, for example, shows us that the number of inpatient visits and the number of medications are most contributing to predictions for these patients. I might actually consider retraining a model just on those top features. What we also love is how easy it is to iterate. You can do that retraining right from here, or you can retrain on a different sample size, even go back, prep data differently, add more data, and run another experiment. We can also perform model actions for a selected model in this model actions dropdown, like make predictions or create a no-code app. Let's navigate to our use case to see an application that was created by another team member already. We designed this experience to facilitate the conversation between you and your stakeholders. With every model should come the right insight so that you can share the context and the why. Why is the patient likely to be readmitted, and what can we do about it? Our model predicts the probability from 0 to 1 that a patient will be readmitted to the hospital. So closer to 1 means they're likely to be readmitted. I'll look for a patient who has a high predicted probability, and then I'll click on them to get some of their basic information, demographic information like age and gender. And I can see what features are most contributing to the prediction that they're going to end up back in the hospital. But then I actually want to reduce risk, so I need to add a scenario and understand how I can lower that prediction score. What if I try discharging them to outpatient services? So it turns out that by discharging this patient to outpatient services, we actually lower the patient's predicted readmission from 88% down to 63%. That's nearly a 30% drop in risk. This app is a separate URL, so you can share with business users. They can take a look on their own and add scenarios based on their subject matter expertise. What we've built here with this suite of experimentation tools allows you to solve your use case and then easily communicate results to your stakeholders to solve the business problem. Today, we are announcing this new DataRobot experience that makes ML experimentation fast, organized, and simple. We've done this with a new collaborative ML workbench with a focus on business use cases.